They flew right through the eye of a Cat 5 hurricane and somehow survived. Now, 25 years later, the crew is back on board that same plane just to share the story behind that unforgettable flight with us. It's Monday morning on AMHQ, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Chance of rain 60%. Tonight, variably cloudy with scattered thunderstorms. Low 76. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Weather Channel takes you this far. Inside a hurricane. Hurricane 360, premiering August 18th at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Welcome back to Weather Center Live. I'm Kate Parker.
And I'm Keith Carson. We're watching Bertha in the tropics. That's our number one story right now. It's on the move, looking a little tiddly bit more organized lately.
Tiddly bit.
Tiddly, just a
smidgen. That's
smid,
a technical term.
A smidgen. More
is that
organized.
Regulation?
Smidgen is, tiddly bit is not. Here's what's happening right now with this system. We take a look at an enhanced satellite. And again, you know, it's all relative. It does have a slightly better center of circulation. It's currently winds 45 miles an hour. There weren't a lot of changes as of the 11 o'clock advisory. We'll be getting a new one shortly. And the pressure 1012, which really is not a very deep storm system. That's what we look for in some of these storms, is not getting any deeper. And it's moving off to the north and west, which has been the ongoing theme, at around 20 miles an hour. So that's the latest on that. Again, we'll get another advisory from the National Hurricane Center pretty shortly. Check out this video showing us some of the impacts in the Caribbean. Monique shot this video from the balcony of her room at the hotel in St. Thomas in the U.S. Virgin Islands. And winds from Bertha there, at least rustling some palm trees. Not super dramatic, but we didn't expect that it would be. Rain has been the biggest impact of this all through Puerto Rico. And check out these waves in Livongo Bay, in the U.S. Virgin Islands. And again, some bigger than average. You have to remember that the water here is typically relatively flat. So we always want to see your videos. You can upload them to our Facebook page, and you can also send us something via Twitter if you're hip and with it. Now, Kate has a look at the other story of the day, which is some showers and some thunderstorms this weekend.
Keith actually still uses a typewriter. He's so not hip and not with it.
Old school.
Yeah, like that's actually how he does everything here at work. Keith, like, stop sending messengers. Tweet at me.
I'm going to page
it's
you.
It's cool.
Yeah, I'm going to page you next.
His pager's constantly going off during the show. I'm like, Keith, come on, dude. All right, let's talk about these storms in the southeast, because we are going to see some of them, and some of these are going to be a little bit troublesome for your plans this week. Let's talk about New Orleans. Not too shabby today, especially if you're there visiting, but if you're planning on heading there on vacation this week, Tuesday looks like your best shot for seeing a few rumbles of thunder. You'll see hit or miss storms otherwise. We've got this pattern of deep moisture hanging out around the southeast, this jet stream kind of wedging it in, keeping it in place, keeping the stationary front just that, stationary. And we are going to see this help trigger several showers and thunderstorms, and we've seen that all morning. If you're in the coastal Carolinas, anywhere from South Carolina through North Carolina along the coast, you know what I'm talking about. You have gotten soaked over the last few days here. Look what's happening. Charleston, you've got a little rain there. Kiawah Island going all the way up here to Hatteras. You just have more and more rain. It just keeps training over the same area. Starting to see it subside just a little bit farther inland. You're getting a brief break in Wilmington, but look back here. You've got more rain on tap for you. So Hatteras just south of there, we've got lightning, just enough to make sure that you can't really go outside at all, even between those breaks, because if you can hear thunder, remember you're under the risk of being struck if you're trying to sneak in a quick break at the beach. Just remember that. Let's talk about the flood concerns, because we are under a flood watch. This is all the way from Windsor, south through New Bern, Wilmington, all the way through Myrtle Beach and then down to Charleston. You have that in effect because we're going to continue to see rain. That's where a lot of our focus of showers and thunderstorms is today. We see that swing all the way back around, though. We're going to continue with that enhanced rain chance all the way around along the Gulf Coast as well. And then tomorrow, right up into the East Coast. By Tuesday, we focus a little farther south down into Florida. Keith?
All right, thanks, Kate. Motown Philly, it's back again. Let's take a look at Philadelphia. Some clouds around and a spider. I love it when spiders are on the tower cams. And, you know, right now, 76, at least it's a little baby spider, though. 76 degrees there right now. And there's some showers and storms across a bunch of Pennsylvania. A lot of them have been out towards State College. We're going to show you that in a second because we're seeing some flooding there with some heavy rainfall. Look, there's a lot of moisture, a lot of juice in the atmosphere. Whenever that happens, you can put down some flash flooding relatively quickly, even though severe weather hasn't been a big concern here. So showers and thunderstorms across all of the Northeast. It's been a theme for a while. Philly, they're the clouds. This is a visible satellite image, so it's just kind of a snapshot looking down on the earth. And there aren't many breaks as far as a cloud. You head out toward New York City, it's a little bit better, but Philly kind of socked in and not much change going on there. Here's where all the action is, though, over western and central Pennsylvania with that upper level low spitting some of that moisture around. And again, some pretty good thunderstorms ongoing there at the moment. Let's zoom into State College. This is where Penn State is. And until 3:15, they have a flash flood warning, some heavy rain moving through there and continuing still to rain at the moment. So you look off to the northwest, here's another one, and look how these cells are just really slow moving. That's the problem, is that we're not getting much more motion out of this, so they're dropping rain in the same spot. Elk and McKean, that's until 3:15 Eastern that we're watching there. And then here's some other pop-up thunderstorms. Really quick, so look at the beginning time of this loop. It's only been about a half hour, and you can see these thunderstorms kind of come out of nowhere. You're going to see a lot more of that as the day wears on, out towards Utica, Syracuse, up to Watertown, Oswego, also involved in some of these showers and storms. So if you take a look at our predicted model, it's just all over the place. These small-scale models do the best they can. They're not going to be perfect. They're just going to pop up showers and storms where they're most likely. So there's the stationary front out there, showers and storms over the ocean. Here's the upper level low, so working up through upstate New York, in through central Pennsylvania, maybe by tonight, getting into eastern Pennsylvania, a little bit into Jersey, and then eventually into western Massachusetts. But the bulk of the action, I think, today and through the early evening is right about here and then up here into western parts of New York State, not making it to the 95 corridor as much. Through tomorrow, now the showers in through northern New England, the mountains of Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, maybe in through the Plattsburgh area, Burlington, Vermont, the Champlain Valley here, seeing some showers and storms as well. Just unstable, not that much in the way of actual severe activity. Kate?
All right, well, let's check out what's going on in the West because we do have that unstable situation going on. We've got all that monsoonal moisture that's just surging on in, and then whenever you get a stalled out front, well, you get some rainfall. Vegas right now, you're mostly cloudy, but you'll notice that every now and then, I know you're getting a little bit of a light little downpour, just a little bit of light rain. Then that's not the case. A little bit farther off to your south, look what's happening. Basically all morning long and all afternoon long now, we've been watching from Flagstaff north, basically the showers and thunderstorms kind of training over some similar spots. The good news is that we're also seeing this happen in California, where we badly need the rain. The thing is that we're not seeing nearly enough to really make up for our drought situation here. What we are looking at are some good soaking rainfalls, but that also means that you could be seeing some flash flood concerns. So we'll be watching for that for today. Make sure you're not driving it into any water. We don't need any water rescues. Let's talk about these scattered thunderstorms. They are going to continue through Arizona, portions of New Mexico, stretching up into the Rockies there, and then a little bit farther off to the west. You'll notice in Nevada, you've got a pretty good chance of seeing thunderstorms this afternoon. We're going to continue that into Southern California for today. Changes in store for tomorrow, though. Take a look at what's going on here. We'll see this kind of lift a little farther off to the north. So Southern California get a little bit of break. But as we get into Tuesday, it's Northern California that gets a little bit of rain. Doesn't matter. California, you need the rain desperately. So you're going to take whatever you can get as long as we don't get it too quickly and have flood concerns. And then Denver along the Front Range, you are going to be a little wet heading into Tuesday. You could see up to an inch in several spots in some isolated areas. You can see much more than that as this rain comes down quickly and or trains over the same area for a long period of time. So 1 to 2 inches, not out of the question through Tuesday morning, just north of Vegas. That's why we have flash flood watches in effect for Nevada, Utah, down into portions of New Mexico and Southern California. Keith?
All right, thanks, Kate. Well, storms are moving in for millions of Americans today, including the Midwest. We're talking about where you can see rain and thunderstorms, and we'll time it out for you as you move into your area. Plus, summer, a great time of the year to take in a movie at the drive-in. We're looking at the best drive-ins in the country, and we'll show you what we found. But first, here's a look at how weather's playing into some weekend events. Pocono Raceway here, some showers and thunderstorms a possibility. NASCAR's got a fancy little drying machine for the racetracks. They might need that there through today. What's our next event here? We're going to talk about some lobster up in Maine. They have this thing in Maine where instead of saying yes, they say ayah. So if you want to go check out some lobster there, looking pretty good. This is typical mid-coastal weather, temperatures in the 60s, kind of socked in a lot of clouds. How about, what is this? Muskin Fest. Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. I don't know. There's some thunderstorms. I'll Google that. But it's not spelled weird. Why is it the K? What is it?
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under cloudy skies. This afternoon, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Chance of rain 50%. Tonight, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. Low 77. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
New DriveGuard tires are engineered to take a puncture and go up to 50 miles.
We can drive 50 miles on a flat, and you have an app that makes nails pop up.
Yep.
We could rule the world. But I've got carpool at 3, though, so
that time.
We could, like, mess with the world.
50 miles on a flat. Because if your tires keep rolling, your day does, too. And there's no better place to get your Bridgestone DriveGuard tires than Firestone Complete Auto Care.
Let's tackle all this with a splash of style. Let's go where they know what matters. Let's do modest budget, major makeover. Let's do, we've got this, and a whole lot of, look what we did. Then let's sit back and enjoy the view. Let's do this. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. For a limited time, shop our newest vanity starting at just $189.
Fruit with a cool finish. Fruit on one side, cool on the other. Icebreakers Duo, a fruity cool way to break the ice.
Go back to class with confidence. Right now at VisionWorks, buy one complete pair of glasses and get another pair free. Any frames, any lenses. Find more than a pair of glasses. Find a better you. VisionWorks.
If you're taking multiple medications, does your mouth often feel dry? A dry mouth can be a side effect of many medications, but it can also lead to tooth decay and bad breath. That's why there's Biotene, available as an oral rinse, toothpaste, spray, or gel. Biotene can provide soothing relief, and it helps keep your mouth healthy, too. Remember, while your medication is doing you good, a dry mouth isn't. Biotene, for people who suffer from dry mouth.
Apron have to do with car insurance? Every time you tie in an apron, you make progress. And we like that. Because progress is what we make too.
Hey, pal. You ready? Can you pick me up at 6:30?
I'm here.
Too late.
I'll go for 5 minutes. Move it. Killing me.
You know what, Dad? I'm good.
It may be quite a while before he's ready, but our Subaru Legacy will be waiting for him.
The longest-lasting midsize sedan in its class. Introducing the all-new Subaru Legacy. It's not just a sedan. It's a Subaru.
Sadly, Angela's gotten used to the odor her cat leaves in the couch. She no longer smells it. Yep, she's gone nose blind. We staged an intervention to help her sister break the news.
This is exactly what your house smells like.
For real?
Yes.
you are tripping. Really?
Febreze Fabric Refresher eliminates pet odors you've gone nose blind to.
Smells good.
One of the many ways Febreze helps you and your guests. Breathe happy.
From residential to commercial, from large loss to emergency response. Whenever damage strikes, call on the cleanup team that's faster to any size disaster at 1-800-SERV-PRO, like it never even happened.
Welcome back to Weather Center Live. Check out this video posted to our Facebook page. A huge hailstorm that rolled through Royal Oak, Michigan. That's a suburb of Detroit. An icy river of hail running down this man's street. And another Facebook poster commented, this is the most hail that they've seen in years there. So some stronger storms. You know, in general, Midwest, Northeast, even down in the Southeast, not a ton of severe potential with this setup. But as you can see, it only takes one or two storms to pop up to be a little bit stronger. You have some hail. And we've seen a lot of flooding rain as well. Flash flooding been an issue. But as we look at the Midwest through early week, we have this little cold front come down from Canada. It doesn't have that much moisture. So well put, limited moisture, only scattered showers and storms. So remember, when we paint these areas in green, it doesn't mean it's going to be raining there the whole time. It means there's a chance for precipitation. So Des Moines, St. Louis, Chicago, Indianapolis into Detroit all have a chance of these showers and storms, but it's certainly not going to be consistent. A trough is built down. It's been built down in the Midwest for the last couple of weeks, about 2 weeks since this jet stream really dug down. It's modified itself, but it's still allowing systems to come down from Canada kind of unabated, and that's what the importance of this jet stream is in this particular case. A lot of times when the jet stream troughs out, instability comes with it. So the jet stream pushes south, and then these little systems rotate around it. We've been watching Kansas City through the morning. They had a few showers around there, another line kind of on the outside of it as well, all light stuff. If we zoom into Kansas City, there were some lightning strikes, but real minimal stuff. You know, a couple here moving down to the south of the city, and a few more scattered kind of garbage showers to the north of the city. But for the most part, again, not severe, just something to think about in Kansas City that we do have some lightning strikes out there. Through tomorrow, we're looking at the same area, Chicago, Green Bay, Detroit. And as we head into the day on Tuesday, not a whole lot of change. The only difference maybe is that it just becomes a little bit more elongated. So now you have your showers through upstate New York. And then on Wednesday, an area that may be a little bit more concentrated out towards Des Moines with a better chance of showers and storms there. Kate?
Well, Keith, Hollywood banks on the summer for their big blockbusters, but not everyone goes inside to see their favorite movie stars. Alex Wallace and Jen Carfagno talked to one of the drive-in theater owners whose establishment is getting national attention about the weather impact on her business.
Well, you know, summertime is a great time to go to the movies, especially if that movie is maybe playing at a drive-in theater.
You can see all your favorite stars under the stars, but good weather is crucial to enjoying this beloved slice of Americana, including the Swan Drive-In in Blue Ridge, Georgia.
And joining us now via Skype is Kathleen Setzer. She's one of the owners. And Kathleen, thanks for joining us. First of all, tell us about how the weather impacts your bottom line.
I'm really always surprised at how many people come despite the weather. I mean, the optimal would be warm and dry, but a lot of people, if they've already made their mind up or their vacation plans to go to the Swan, come out anyway. I think there are so few drive-ins around that people just want the experience, so they're willing to brave the weather.
Do you still show movies in the rain?
We do. A lot of people even like sitting in the coziness of their own vehicle with a blanket and somebody with them and watch it anyway. If you have a really, really cold winter or a lot of snow, that type of stuff, that really affects the bottom line, of course. You know, there are areas that don't have the milder seasons that we do have in the South. We do get some cold weather, but, you know, it's very rare for us to get a snowstorm or anything that's going to shut us down for 3 or 4 days. So we pretty much can just keep on going. We're full-time during the summer and then just weekends year-round. So very rarely do we have anything that will shut us down because of the weather.
Now, you guys had storm damage in, I believe it was April of 2011, that almost forced you to maybe shut things down. What happened? Can you describe it?
Well, in April 2011, there were a lot of storms in this area, and the screen got significant damage in the top right corner, tore off a lot of the panels. The screen was old. I mean, it was built in 1955, and it had a wooden structure. So when they came to repair the screen, and they realized that there was structural damage to the inside. So the screen actually had to be removed, and we put up a new screen, which is steel, which will be here long after we're all dead. Without that, the Swan would have been out of business.
Wow.
I love me some drive-ins.
I mean, I haven't been to one in a long time. Maybe I need to go.
For this one in Atlanta, check it out. Hey, Caribbean vacations were a bust on Saturday thanks to Bertha.
I know. Coming up, where Bertha is headed and the damage that it's leaving behind.
Also, why you might want to look up in the sky tonight before you lay down, unless you lay down like us at 7 p.m. But in general, check it out.
And the sun's still up.
First morning ever. Best morning ever.
Warm, flaky, gooey, tosasuro.
In the nation, the safest feature in your car is you. Add vanishing deductible from Nationwide Insurance and get $100 off for every year of safe driving. Which for you shouldn't be a problem. Just another way we put members first, because we don't have shareholders. Join the nation.
Nationwide is on your side.
Only the Weather Channel drops you into nature's deadliest predicaments and asks, so you think you'd survive?
Oh my God!
Premiering next Sunday at 9 on the Weather Channel.
This summer on NBCSN, the boats are in the water, the sharks are on the hook, and there's money on the line.
What's the move, baby? That's how you do it!
It's the season premiere of Shark Hunters, Wednesday starting at 9 on NBCSN.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under cloudy skies. This afternoon, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Chance of rain 50%. Tonight, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. Low 77. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
To you by Terminix. Call 1-800-TERMINIX or go to Terminix.com for our mosquito solutions.
We fight a war against every foul pest that haunts your home. Backed by 85 years of experience and the strongest guarantee in the business, it's not exactly a fair fight. Not here, not now, not in my house. Terminix.
We have pinpoint which we felt needed further work.
Precision Match is the best brake service to make stopping as smooth as humanly possible. Trust the boys to get you there.
Sonic has like every slush flavor someone could ever want.
That's right. This is basically slush headquarters.
Where Sour Blue Raspberry plans world domination.
What?
Get colorful with new Sonic slushes, now available with Nerds Candy. This is how you Sonic.
Do you remember the hassle of vacuuming before the Dyson Digital Motor? Before it gave the DC59 Motorhead powerful suction and perfect balance in your hand for cleaning those difficult-to-reach places? And before our direct drive cleaner head increased brush bar power by 75%, DC59 Motorhead outcleans the 5 best-selling full-size vacuums across carpets and hard floors without the hassle of a cord.
It's the candy bar that's too hot for TV. In all its naked glory. Stripped of chocolate with nothing but salty roasted peanuts on soft, sweet caramel. A payday bar will get you through your day. Expose yourself to payday.
They keep us busy.
Duck fishing.
You wanna go lower,
they keep us entertained. They keep us inspired. They keep us hopeful and happy. Keep them safe. 28 passengers. Maybe he's really focused.
Hey, Michael. Maybe he likes spinning the wheels.
Maybe he just loves trucks.
Maybe he's just being a boy.
Preoccupation with objects is one early sign of autism. Learn the others today. The sooner it's diagnosed, the better.
The Indian River Lagoon is 156 miles long, representing recreation, fishing, and nearly 20,000 Florida jobs. Last summer, because of dumping in Lake Okeechobee, the lagoon turned green and murky.
I call it a disaster. So we pulled together to stop the dumping with record funding that will protect this vital resource and our jobs.
Joe Negron had it in his heart to do what's right for this lagoon.
It's our future.
Joe Negron, coming through for us.
4-6.
Premier Bad is the best gift I ever gave to myself.
Only the Weather Channel drops you into nature's deadliest predicaments and asks, so you think you'd survive?
Oh my God!
Premiering next Sunday at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Welcome back. Here's a live look at Pine Cay and Turks Island. This is a camera with, you know, Bertha on the move, and obviously some raindrops here. Looking a little bit ominous, at least a little bit, with some raindrops. Not much wind.
Yeah, not a lot of wind going on there, but, you know, rain has been a lot of the story because the sustained wind's about 45 miles an hour with this storm, and that's right there around the center, so.
Yeah, let's actually get to Dr. Greg Postel because we just had a new advisory come out. What'd you find in that?
You know, I wish I could say I found it, but, you know, the Hurricane Center did. 45 miles per hour, so no change. The 2 o'clock advisory, hot off the presses, 45 miles per hour, moving northwest now at 18. That's slowed down a few miles per hour. That means to me that maybe it's beginning to change direction a little bit. So 45 and northwest at 18. It was northwest at 21 earlier. And now it's slowed down a bit. There it is on the satellite pictures. We got a whole bunch of big thunderstorms right there in the bright whites. And there is a mid-level circulation in here somewhere, not far away from those thunderstorms. And we do think there is at least a little bit of a low-level circulation too. So they're trying to at least line up the circulations and the big thunderstorms. But it will take a while. I think the atmosphere not quite ready to see them both flourish or the whole thing develop further. But we'll see, and it might just do that as it moves northwestward over some warmer waters and the atmosphere becomes just a little bit more favorable for development. But it kind of pales in comparison to what's going on the East Coast right now. There's a lot of rain, a ton of rain with a frontal zone and an old tropical wave. And Bertha moving this way may actually kind of interact with it, at least sort of on its extension, on its periphery, and enhance some of the rainfall here. But overall, Bertha's going to be going to take a right turn out to sea, and I'll show you exactly why. Because if you look at the wind flow at upper levels, bingo, this is unmistakable, guys. There's the jet stream kind of shaping out like that. Bertha down here is going that way. No doubt about it. We're all pretty sure about that. That's one thing. Bertha's going to remain way offshore, and you can see it hundreds of miles off the coast of Florida overnight tonight and then tomorrow morning. But look, it's got a pretty cool looking structure in there. So the models are suggesting, like others are, that this is going to intensify in this sector of the Atlantic Ocean. But the good news is it can do all it's intensifying. It wants. Because you know what? It's going out to sea, and there it goes. Here's the track, and you can see the Hurricane Center has it going up to 75. Look at that, 75 miles per hour on a northeastward track over the colder ocean waters. Now, I got to turn our attention to the West Pacific because this is a monster, a ferocious typhoon out here. It was a Cat 5. It's allegedly got 150 mile per hour winds, but looking at the satellite pictures right now, I think it's weakening. You can see some of the internal structure here perhaps falling apart a bit. Just for reference, there's Guam and there are the Philippines. And here's the track for Super Typhoon Halong. It is going to be moving northward and maybe get very close to our friends in Japan late in the week as still a hurricane, perhaps as strong as a Cat 2. Of course, they call them typhoons out that way. It's still the same system. But Japan could be in for it later on in the week. Stay tuned. Guys, back to you.
Thanks, Dr. Postel.
Yeah, Japan has been hit hard this year, for sure.
Well, the West Pac, so active.
Right, very hot lately. Well, tonight, be sure to keep your eyes to the sky. If you're a stargazer, you're in for a cool show.
Yeah, a rare conjunction of planets will provide an amazing sight in the night sky. Kelly Beatty with Sky and Telescope Magazine has a preview. Thank you.
You know, if you're a beginning sky gazer, it's kind of hard to tell where the stars are and where the planets are. Here's a slam dunk way to find two bright planets in the evening sky. August 3rd, the first quarter moon will be sandwiched between Saturn on the left and Mars on its right. The whole arrangement will take up about the width of your fist stretched out at arm's length. Now, Saturn and Mars look about equally bright, but that's deceiving. Mars is 110 million miles away from us right now, and Saturn is almost a billion miles away. It looks about as bright as Mars because it's so much bigger a planet. Check it out, and I hope you have clear skies.
Well, stay with us. We have the very latest on Bertha as we continue our coverage on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees with showers. This afternoon, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Chance of rain 50%. Tonight, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. Low 77. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
A live look at Port Everglades and Fort Lauderdale, Florida. There's cruise ships there. You can kind of see them in the background. Well, they should be out to sea by now, but there's a problem with that.
Yeah, just a little problem called Bertha. This tropical storm is very close to where a lot of those ships are heading. They go to the Bahamas quite often from there. And if you are going to be in the Bahamas, it could be a little bit of a rough ride. We'll tell you more about it. From the Weather Channel headquarters in Atlanta, this is a special edition of Weather Center Live. So Tropical Storm Bertha continues to make its way through the Caribbean. And in case you forgot who we were, if you weren't with us for the last few hours here, I'm Kate Parker.
I'm Keith Carson. I'm not offended if you already forgot. A new advisory just came out a few minutes ago from the National Hurricane Center. Let's take a look at what it found. And in short, Kate, not much of a change here.
Yeah, the forward motion slowed down a little bit with this system, only traveling now at about 18 miles an hour. So that's about 3 miles an hour slower than last advisory. But, you know, this storm has changed a lot from yesterday to today.
Yeah. Organizationally and otherwise. Let's get now to Dr. Greg Postel, who's going to bring us the latest on exactly what's going on with Bertha.
Watching the visible satellite pictures, you get a sense that maybe it's trying to get its act together at least a little bit. Not very quickly, still a 45-mile-per-hour tropical storm, but we did notice on the motion it was going now at 18 miles per hour. Earlier today it was at 21, so it's slowing down just a little bit. That suggests that maybe it is about to turn or change direction a little bit. Let's have a look at the satellite pictures, and you can see where it is, Turks and Caicos Islands and here the Bahamas. The weather's actually pretty good there right now, but if you look at what's going on here, we got some big thunderstorms of bright whites right in there, and there is a mid-level swirly. We know that a few thousand feet above the ground, not far away from there, I don't think, and also a low-level swirly as well that is essentially closed off. It's very weak near the ground, but we have found some west winds underneath that. So we've got a system that's got a circulation with some thunderstorms very nearby, and maybe that's a sort of a beginning to the setup of strengthening, and we'll see. But what we've got also here is still some dry air aloft, and some of the planes have been flying in and out earlier today, and did note that it was still pretty dry, and we have some enough strong winds to get that dry air in there. So overall, the atmosphere is not great for intensification, but I think it will improve over the next 24 to 48 hours. There's where Bertha is, and sort of in the larger context, you can see that we've got a whole lot of messy weather along the East Coast. There's an old frontal zone that came down there. There's a tropical wave that's moved in from the east. So it's just a messy, long strip of very, I guess, what's the word? Impactful weather here, all the way from the coastal Carolinas down through Florida. And as Bertha gets a little bit closer, it may begin to interact, at least on the periphery of the circulation of Bertha, may begin to interact with this and enhance some of the rainfall near the Bahamas. So we will be watching for that later on today. But overall, the steering currents for Bertha are clear. crystal clear, really. They've been that way for a while. We've had a low-level subtropical high that's been doing its job and bringing Bertha around like that. And we've got an upper-level wind flow now that's pretty well established that you can see is giving Bertha a pretty narrow corridor to move through. I put the jet stream flow in here to show you that we've got a circulation like that at upper levels, and Bertha is going to be going that way, also being steered by the low-level flow as well. So all in all, it's pretty clear cut on where it's going, a long way from the coast of the United States. Tomorrow morning, early in the morning, hundreds of miles to the east of the Florida coast. And you could guess that the core circulation about like that, maybe even smaller, is a long way from the coast and will not have any direct impacts on the beaches there. There will be quite a bit of rain, I think, on the Carolina coast, perhaps even on Monday afternoon as well. But that's not directly related to Bertha, because Bertha is going this way. And it will be doing so more quickly with each passing day, with the possibility of strengthening even to a hurricane. But that's, again, well out over the ocean waters. Let's have a look in the West Pac, the West Pacific, because we have a super typhoon out there. And it was a very, very formidable tropical cyclone. Still is, no doubt about it. But I think on the satellite pictures, we get a sense that maybe it's losing a little bit of its intensity. Not a lot. Still a nasty, nasty storm. Estimated to have winds of 150 miles per hour moving toward the west at 8. I'm going to look at some satellite estimates next time around. I'll see if indeed they're still going 150. I wouldn't be surprised if they've come down a little bit. But regardless, it's going this way, and it's going toward Japan, and may get very close to them by the end of this week. So interest in the Japanese island chain, especially south of the mainland, need to be very careful and watch closely the progress of Super Typhoon Halong. In the tropics on the East Pacific, we've got an invest, we've got Hurricane Izelle, and we've got Hawaii. Those three things we need to keep in mind, because Hurricane Izelle is a powerful Category 3 hurricane, 115 right now, and it's going this way. Hawaii is right in the cone late in the week as a fortunately weakened 50 mile per hour system. But look, on its heels, here comes Invest 97L. So Izelle is out in front, and this one is stalking it from behind, kind of on the same path. Could it be? Could it move very close to Hawaii? You just have to wait and see. It might do that, guys. Hawaii could be at risk for multiple tropical cyclone, I should say, impacts to some degree late next week. Stay tuned for all that. Back to you.
Clearly, we will be keeping a close eye on that. Thank you so much, Dr. Postel. The bay that you're looking at in this video, bringing it a little bit more recent here, is Chocolate Hole. It's in the southwest end of St. John in the U.S. Virgin Islands. Ben Bett sent us this video while Bertha roared through that area. And you can clearly see pretty windy, pretty wet. But the good news is that impacts, for the most part, were minimal. Most of the problems have been from the tremendous amount of rain that we've seen with this system.
Yeah, rain's been a bigger issue for sure.
Yeah, a lot of you have been sending us your videos from the storm, so thank you.
Yeah, we do appreciate that. You post them on our Facebook wall. It's always a good practice there. Here's one of the first looks that we're getting here in the British Virgin Islands, and heavy rain squalls and lots of rain in Tortola. Tortola is the largest and most populated on the British Islands, and that's actually, this looks like some decent wind gusts there for sure. Although, you know, the tarp is telling because it would be up in the air if it were a little bit stronger, but still, not bad.
Yeah, you definitely, not a great vacation day, but not too shabby here. This is a look from Monique. She shot this from the video of her balcony from the room in St. Thomas in the U.S. Virgin Islands. Winds from Bertha rustling the palm trees there a bit. Clearly not going to be a great day on Emerald Bay there in St. Thomas, but, you know, it could have been worse,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah, for sure. And great hotel room, by the way. Just northeast of St. Thomas is Livongo Cay. It's also part of the Virgin Islands, and some decent waves there. You have to remember, in general, this is a pretty flat part of the ocean. So, you know, you see oceans like this in a lot of places. This is not normal for them, though.
Yeah, it's not typical to see waves that high, see the water that high. Let's go back to Puerto Rico. This is on the southeastern part of the island that we're looking here. Look at the waves there. Now, this is a little bit better picture of just how rough the surf has been. And clearly, if you're on vacation or trying to vacation, which a lot of folks are, sneaking in before school starts, a little bit of a trouble spot for you.
All right, we're going to be right back talking more about Bertha and the tropics in general.
Oh no. Can you fix it, Dad?
Yeah, I can fix that.
I wanted a car that could handle anything.
I fixed it!
That's why I got a Subaru Legacy. Symmetrical all-wheel drive plus 36 MPG.
I gotta break more toys.
Introducing the all-new Subaru Legacy. It's not just a sedan, it's a Subaru.
Hey, Super Mama.
You gotta check out this Walmart back-to-school event.
Okay.
A Toshiba Touch laptop, just $349.
Sounds good.
Super comfy boy socks, only $497.
Oh, I definitely need socks.
Sharpie permanent markers, only $397.
That sounds good. Wow. A 10-inch tablet with a built-in keyboard.
That sounds good.
Get to Walmart's back-to-school savings event August 1st through 10th and save even more on Cyber Monday, August 4th. Save money, live better. Walmart.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees with showers. This afternoon, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Chance of rain 50%. Tonight, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. Low 77. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Nature's deadliest predicaments and asks, so you think you'd survive?
Oh my God!
Premiering next Sunday at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Bridgestone's new Drive Guard tires are engineered to take a puncture and go up to 50 miles.
We can drive 50 miles on a flat, and you have an app that makes nails pop up.
Yep.
We could rule the world. But I've got carpool at 3, though, so
that time
we could, like, mess with the world.
50 miles on a flat. Because if your tires keep rolling, your day does, too. And there's no better place to get your Bridgestone Drive Guard tires than Firestone Complete Auto Care.
Each year, 95% of homeowners won't have a claim. That's why Allstate Claim Free Rewards gives you money back for every year you don't have one. And why, if you're part of the other 5%, Allstate offers Claim Rate Guard, so your rates won't go up just because of a claim.
No matter what comes your way, your home protects you. Protect it back. Allstate Home Insurance. I'm an Allstate agent.
All the goodness of milk, all the deliciousness of Hershey's syrup. Squeeze, stir, share.
Welcome back to a special extended version of Weather Center Live, bringing you the very latest on Bertha. Let's go ahead and discuss what we've got going on right now. Now, you may notice some cruise ships. They are sitting in port. This is in Nassau. You can see here. Doesn't look too shabby, but we are going to be watching as this tropical storm does approach the Bahamas. Conditions there may deteriorate. Here's what we've got going on with this. So winds right now, 45 miles an hour. This is with the latest advisory. We've got a slower forward motion here. We were moving at about 21 miles an hour. The storm now only has a forward motion about 18 miles an hour, so it has slowed up just a bit. And overnight last night, while you were sleeping, it did become a little better organized. That being said, still not an overly impressive tropical storm. It is still approaching the Bahamas, though. The southeastern Bahamas starting to feel the impacts from this system, Keith.
All right, thanks, Kate. You know, on the whole, it has been busier in the Pacific. Take a look at this right now. We're talking about the Atlantic, of course. But if the Atlantic was talking trash, Pacific would be like, scoreboard. They've had so many more systems there. Right now, three we're watching. We got Invest, we got Azelle, we got Genevieve, which has died and then came back to life. A lot more going on, and just a moisture train coming in off the west coast here of Mexico. So there's a couple of systems. You can see them right there. And the one in the middle obviously catches your eye for being the strongest looking. There's an eye in in that actual system. A tropical depression, Genevieve, remember at one point that was considered not a tropical storm, then back up to a depression, winds at 35 miles an hour, and it's 830 miles to the south of Honolulu. That will continue to just kind of drift off to the west, so we're not too concerned about what that's going to do. That's good news, even though it will try to re-strengthen through Thursday morning. It's out over the open water, so no worries there. Now, Azelle is a different story. It is a Category 3 storm. That's the one I pointed out is looking stronger, and that's the one that has a chance, as Dr. Postel mentioned, of impacting Hawaii as we head into later in the work week. Kate?
Well, Keith, a lot to see in the tropics right now. We developed a system that helps us look a bit further into the future. Our senior hurricane specialist, Brian Norcross, explains what could fuel an upcoming storm.
As we look ahead to the next 2 weeks in the tropics, we first look at the big macro factors around the Earth that can make tropical development a little more favorable or unfavorable. The first one, kind of a big one, is called the MJO. Madden-Julian Oscillation is the technical name of it. And it rotates around the globe at the equator, and it's one of the things that can enhance development. Another one is called the Kelvin Wave. It also rotates around, but it goes faster. And when those two line up, well, the tropics become more favorable for development, and when they're out of phase or when neither of them are enhancing, the tropics become somewhat unfavorable for development. Somewhat unfavorable. So where do we stand here this week going on to the next week? We have a general favorable area here over the Atlantic. There's Africa over there. Here we are on the other side. So that's why we've seen some effort at development. This is not the only factor, but this enhances development a little bit, and of course we saw that earlier this week and on into next week. We think that factor will still be in place, but moving on out as we head toward mid-August, the enhanced development area moves out and an unfavorable area moves in over the Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean. So that will tend to squash tropical development. On top of that, we have the upper level winds. They look like they're going to be unfavorable into mid-August, both over the main development region there in the tropics and also over here, the Gulf of Mexico and over near us. So the net-net of all this, looking next week into mid-August, we think generally increasingly unfavorable next week, especially by late in the week, and then into mid-August, mostly unfavorable in the tropics. Doesn't mean nothing can develop, just means the atmosphere is not primed for development. Okay, that's it. Back to you.
All right, thank you. Well, Bertha continues to move into the southeastern Bahamas. We're going in depth with the system next. Stay with us. We're in special coverage of Tropical Storm Bertha to keep you prepared in the Caribbean.
After winning 10 gold gloves, I know when I've made a great catch. That's why for over 10 years, I've used Blue Emu. It's made with real emu oil. It's a non-greasy, deep-penetrating formula that works itself down into my joints. And now for those hard-to-reach places, there's new Blue Emu Pain Relief Spray. Odorless, made with an active ingredient for pain relief. It will soothe those muscles and get down into that joint pain. Take it from me. It works fast and you won't stink. Blue Emu. It works for me. It'll work for you.
So, Duke, what do you think for our new Bush's Baked Beans video game?
I think I'm getting the hang of it.
Now, roll that beautiful bean footage. Yes.
Bush's Baked Beans are slow-cooked according to our secret family recipe for big flavor. Enjoy Bush's Baked Beans.
West didn't end where Columbus landed. Not on the banks of the Mississippi or even the coast of California. The new Ram 1500 EcoDiesel, with 9,200 pounds of towing and 28 highway miles per gallon. West will never end. Guts, glory, Ram.
When I had my first migraine, I was lucky. That sounds crazy, I know, but my mom got migraines, so she knew this would help. Excedrin Migraine starts to relieve my pain in 30 minutes, plus sensitivity to light, sound, even nausea. Excedrin Migraine works.
Need brakes? Pep Boys has the best brake service at the best price. Right now, get $50 off instantly on Precision Match Brake Service exclusively at Pep Boys. That's 50 off instantly. Trust the boys to get you there.
Huh, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Yeah, everybody knows that.
Well, did you know that playing cards with Kenny Rogers gets old pretty fast?
You got to know when to hold 'em, know when to fold 'em, know when to walk away. know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. What? You get it.
I get the gist, yeah. Okay.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
I'm taking a beating here down to the ground as we're just dealing with these sheets of rain and winds that are howling 50, 60 miles per hour.
It's on. The games are on. The coverage is on. The action is on the all-new SEC Network. And it's all on Xfinity, where you get the most live college football, including the Pac-12 networks, the Big Ten Network, and ESPN Goal Line. Plus, the X1 Sports app to experience it all like never before. You can't get all this with DirecTV. Enjoy the all-new SEC Network on TV and on the go with Watch ESPN starting August 14th. On Xfinity, your home for the most live sports.
Wow, something smells yummy.
I'm making spaghetti. You want a taste?
No, thanks. I'll wait.
Cooking with our new Kinetico water from Aquasoft makes our food taste so much better. And our pasta is to die for. I love cooking now.
Oh, I'm so glad. Listen, I'm going to change and get comfortable. Is someone coming for dinner?
Oh, didn't I tell you? My mother's coming.
Really? So much for getting comfortable. Call Aquasoft today and get your great Kinetico water. You'll be really glad you did.
5 to get a free brochure. 1-800-382-1905.
Only the Weather Channel drops you into nature's deadliest predicaments and asks, so you think you'd survive?
Oh my God!
Premiering next Sunday at 9 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Chance of rain 50%. Tonight, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. Low 77. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
To the Weather Channel, incredible time-lapse video of Bertha as it moved across Puerto Rico yesterday. The heaviest rains fell in Puerto Rico's southern and eastern regions, causing nearly 39,000 power outages there. The storm forced hundreds into government-run shelters. And since the storm has moved away from U.S. territories in the Caribbean, we've been getting a better look at what it was like and what it did.
Everything that you're about to see is from Puerto Rico. This video was shot in San Juan, right in the middle of the storm. We've been talking about dangers. Here's this video that we were talking about. Well, we're trying to go to it. Look at this. For instance, there was some flooding, but overall, Bertha was welcomed help for the drought on the island. You can see that we did see some roads washed out, but this rainfall badly needed. They are in a moderate drought for much of the island. It just didn't need to come down this quickly.
Just came down real fast, especially in those higher terrain areas. And there was also some damage, which I think was the picture we were just trying to show you there. This is PR 174 in August Buenos, I think that's how you say it, hopefully, is a brand new hole right in the middle of that road, unfortunately. As much as 7 inches of rain fell, it was heaviest there in the western mountains. Now, is moving towards the Bahamas. Let's get the latest on Bertha from Dr. Postow.
Yes, Keith, let's do that. You know, we have Tropical Storm Bertha getting very close now to the Bahamas, continuing to be a 45-mile-per-hour tropical storm. It slowed down its forward progress now at 18 miles per hour. It was earlier 21 toward the northwest, now still northwest at 18. But that slower motion, just ever so slightly, may be the sign that it's about ready to turn a more northward trajectory rather than northwestward. We'll see how that happens during the rest of the afternoon. There it is. Again, not a very big circulation, at least the core of it. Here are the big thunderstorms right in here, those bright whites now moving just toward the northwest of the Turks and Caicos. There's a mid-level circulation here. There's pretty good evidence of a low-level circulation, although much, much weaker. But still, we got some signs that maybe this is trying to get its act together and intensify a little bit. It's got a ways to go. because there's still some dry air nearby and a few other factors in play. But it's going toward the northwest, and over the next couple of days may have an opportunity to strengthen a little bit when it's out over the warm waters of the western Atlantic. You can see it in sort of context with what's going along the east coast. There is a ton of rain here. I mean, this is associated with a frontal zone, an old tropical wave. It's a very complicated system here on the east coast. And Bertha, relatively diminutive compared to that, but still, there may be some interaction on Bertha's track that brings it a little bit more closely to that area of disturbed weather off the east coast, and that may enhance some rainfall out here. But otherwise, Bertha is essentially going to be heading out to sea. The core of it, there's no real question here, and there hasn't been, with Bertha's steering currents at many levels of the atmosphere taking it on a path like that. One of those levels of the atmosphere up near the jet stream shows that very clearly. You've got the dip in the jet stream in the east. You've got a little bit of a circulation out like that. This is where Bertha's going, and you can do this at many, slice and dice your way through the atmosphere how many ways you want it. It's pretty clear that Bertha will be hundreds of miles off the coast throughout the forecast period. There it is tomorrow morning. There's the Florida East Coast. There's Bertha, and it continues to go north and then northeastward. Here's the center of circulation. Not all that expansive, but it does show perhaps at least some sign here in the weather models that it's got a little bit of a more coherent structure there by late tomorrow, suggesting that in the models anyway, it's probably strengthening. So we have that to look forward to, I think, during the next 24 to 48 hours. Who's going to get the tropical storm force winds? Well, the probabilities are highest in red here in purple and lowest in the green. The Bahamas have generally a 5 to 25% chance of seeing tropical storm force winds. That's about 40 miles per hour and above. And notice that the Outer Banks have about a 5% chance of seeing tropical storm force winds. So really, it's highly likely that the main action is going to be way out here. Even Nova Scotia has only a small chance of seeing some big winds. Let's have a look now. The official cone from the Hurricane Center taking it out that way, like you just saw. But they bring it up to a 75 mile per hour category one, suggesting the atmosphere around it does get at least temporarily favorable for development. Let's go now to the West Pacific, because we've got Super Typhoon Halong. It is estimated to have 150 mile per hour winds, but I don't think it's that strong. I looked at some more recent satellite estimates, and more like 135 is what we're dealing with, I think, here. Of course, plus or minus a whole bunch, but the idea is that it's a little bit weaker than it was 12 hours ago. You've lost some of the cloud tops here, and the eye is not clearly visible like it was earlier. So still, it's a big, nasty, nasty tropical cyclone that is going northward and probably get very close to Japan. It's a pretty potent system late in the week. Now in the East Pacific, gosh, we have to pay attention to Izel, Hurricane Izel, Cat 3, and Invest 97E, because Izel, potent storm right now heading toward the west. It's got Hawaii in its sights. They're in the cone late in the week. And behind it, watch Invest 97E sort of stalk Hurricane Izel as it goes on toward the west. It may very well get close to Hawaii. Stay tuned for all the latest, as Hawaii may be at risk for some tropical cyclones. We'll be back later.
I'm a painter, and Scotch Blue is my take.
I am a painter, and Scotch Blue is my take.
Pro painters count on Scotch Blue, now with advanced edge-lock paint line protector for even sharper paint lines.
I am a painter, and Scotch Blue is my take.
Scotch Blue Painter's Take.
When he first joined the Army, I was very nervous.
We didn't know what they would have him doing. But Bobby always had a plan.
With unmatched training in over 150 careers beyond the battlefield, there are over 150 surprising ways to become Army strong. Talk to your son or daughter about opportunities in the Army.
With diabetes, it's tough to keep life balanced. I don't always have time to eat like I should. That's why I like Lucerna shakes. They have slowly digestible carbs to help minimize blood sugar spikes.
Lucerna, the number one doctor-recommended brand.
Anticipate the walk to come. Create more moments like this and save 50% on hundreds of items like collars, dog toys, and dog treats at PetSmart.
This time of year, you just need some fertilizer with weed control and a spreader to distribute it evenly. It's not rocket horticulture.
Oh. It's not rocket grilling either, right, guys?
Getting help at Ace is like going to your neighbor.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Go back to class with confidence.
Right now at VisionWorks, buy one complete pair of glasses and get another pair free. Any frames, any lenses. Find more than a pair of glasses. Find a better you. VisionWorks.
Discover Brookside and discover an exciting combination of tastes. Rich, dark chocolate, covering soft centers, flavored with exotic fruit juices. It's chocolate and fruit flavors like you've never experienced before. Discover Brookside.
They keep us busy.
Duck fishing.
You wanna go lower?
They keep us entertained. They keep us inspired. They keep us hopeful and happy. Keep them safe. The 8-passenger Chevrolet Traverse with the highest possible overall vehicle score for safety. Chevrolet. Find new roads.
Currently in our area, 84 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. High 87. Chance of rain 50%. Tonight, variable clouds with scattered thunderstorms. Low 77. Chance of rain 60%. Here's our 7-day outlook.
You into nature's deadliest predicaments and asks, so you think you'd survive?
Oh my God!
Premiering next Sunday at 9 on the Weather Channel.
I want to give you another update on Tropical Storm Bertha. If you are planning a trip to the Bahamas, not a great time to do so. Right now, winds are 45 miles an hour. That forward motion just a little bit slower, moving to the northwest at 18 miles an hour. You can see that it is overnight it was slightly better organized. Not looking too shabby on satellite right now. We do have tropical storm warnings in place. That's for here, the eastern edge of Hispaniola, the Dominican Republic there. Turks and Caicos, you are still under a tropical storm warning that extends into the southeastern Bahamas. We are anticipating quite a lot of rainfall here, and you'll notice we have a lot of rain here. In the northern Bahamas as well, and in Miami, South Florida this morning, a lot of moisture hanging out there. But this is the system. Here it is. It is making its way into the Bahamas as we speak. We're anticipating that it'll make a little bit of a shift here off to the northeast over the next couple of days. Could see some strengthening, but should remain out to sea. You still could see some moisture along the coast, but that's actually from another system, so bear that in mind as you make your plans. We're back with updates throughout the day, and we'll be here live with the next advisory.
We are carrying limited amounts of air on our backs, but at this point, James is running out. He could die.
Do you see his bubbles anywhere?
No.
James, do you copy? I'm not able to hail the captain, and we're just hoping everything's okay. Oh, I see them. Diver up!
I'm glad that James is safe, but it's kind of unfair. What if something happened to me? If we were diving together and something happened to me and he was low on air, there's no way he could help me.
Wasn't really much there. Now it's coming back up, just like clockwork. He rolls right in behind me. So I kick back.
I'm chasing him into a cave.
You want to have a look at what Safety Captain came up with?
Oh, not cool. Yeah, not. I'm not laughing
triple
at that.
Triple zeros.
I'm not laughing at that.
Do as I say, not as I do.
Yeah, you shouldn't do that either. It just could have been really bad.
You know, Lisa kind of put me on the spot here. Sometimes your ego gets the best of you, but then after you have time to settle down and the adrenaline goes away, you think about how stupid you were. And it really wasn't worth it. I'm sorry, guys.
How you guys doing down there?
All good.
Can't quite hear what they're doing. It sounds like they're busy shooting fish. We're starting to get into the time of year. The water temperature's changing a little, and when it starts to get cold, the barracuda move off of these wrecks. So this is kind of our last chance to get them this year. We're out here shooting these barracuda. We've got about half of our barracuda quota filled. Hopefully, we can get the rest on this dive.
The big ones are coming around, but I don't see any.